Welcome friends and welcome to my series of video lectures on theory of structures. We are studying the topic of portal frames, and in the earlier video we have started a numerical problem on portal frame bending moment diagram by moment distribution method. In this video lecture we will continue the same problem. In the topic of portal frames, we are solving a problem on bending moment diagram for non-sway frame by moment distribution method. This problem and this topic comes under the course outcome E, that is application of moment distribution method for the portal frames and continuous beams. In the previous video, we have already started a numerical problem on drawing the bending moment diagram of this portal frame. We have covered step 1 and step 2 in the previous video. As I mentioned in the earlier video, let me mention it again, that in this video I am assuming that you are conversant with the moment distribution method for continuous beams and you are able to solve the problems on continuous beam using moment distribution method. If by any reason you are not conversant with moment distribution method, I will request you to refer to my video on the introduction to moment distribution method so that it will be easier for you to understand this problem. Now, I will just continue with step 3 in this problem. To get a quick review, we will just revise what we studied in the last video. This is the portal frame. We have straightened it as A, B, C, D, a continuous beam. So the first step is to straighten the portal frame into a continuous beam. So at B and at C, we have introduced two supports, roller supports, which act as continuous supports in place of the joints B and C, which are rigid joints. So now this beam has become a continuous beam, and according to the principle of moment distribution method, in the first place we are assuming all supports to be fixed, so that AB, BC and CD, they are three separate fixed beams. That gives rise to the step 1, that since there are three separate fixed beams, we calculate fixed end moments for AB, BC and CD as separate spans. So this we have done in the last video. The step 2 is distribution factors for joint B and joint C. At joint B and at joint C, we have calculated total 4 values of distribution factors. Now we are in step 3. In step 3, we are going to write the moment distribution table for this beam. Now all of us are familiar with this format of moment distribution table. We will now go on filling this table and solve the problem. So the first row in the table is joints. So we will be writing the names of the joints. This is A. This is B. As a convention, we are encircling their names A, B, C and D. Strictly speaking, B and C are the only joints because two beams are meeting there. A and D are the normal supports. Now in the second row, we will write the distribution factor values. We see in step 2, for joint B, there are BA and BC two beams meeting. So the distribution will be done in the proportion 3 by 7, that is equal to 0.43 for BA and 0.57 for BC. So this is 0.43 for BA and 0.57 for BC. Similarly, for joint C, CB 0.57 and CD 0.43. Sorry. So this is the second part. Now, the next part is fixed end moments. In this table, we will be writing the values of the fixed end moments which we have calculated. So, that the fixed end moments are calculated in step 1. AB. MAB equal to MBA equal to 0 because there is no load here. So AB means you will write it here. BA means you will write it here. So both are 0. For BC, MBC is equal to minus 6. So it is important to write at proper position in the table. Then the second value is minus MCB equal to minus 6 kN. So this minus goes and you get MCB equal to plus 6 kN. Then MCD and MDC both are 0 because there is no load on CD. So here we get this 0 and this 0. So these are the fixed end moments at the various points. Now we have to go to the next step or next part of this table. The next part is release of joints which were not originally fixed. I will repeat. Next step is release of the joints which were not originally fixed. Now if you look at the joint B and joint C are all the supports, you will find that A and D are originally fixed. So they are not to be released. But B and C were originally simply supported. But we made them fixed in the step 1 assumption. So now we will release them. We will release joint B and joint C. So the next step is release of B and C. What is the meaning of release of B and C? How can we release them? We have held them wrongly, so we are correcting it by applying a correction moment. So let us look at joint B. At joint B, we are having two moments, 0 and minus 6. So these two moments create an imbalance. Actually, if there was a continuous beam here, then both of these values would be equal. So we will release them means we will calculate a correction moment and we will distribute that correction moment. Now what is going to be the correction moment? We will write the correction moment. This is 0 and this is minus 6. So we will have a correction moment of plus 6 here and we will distribute that plus 6 by 43% on this side and 57% on this side. So the correction moment will be distributed in that proportion. So what we will do is plus 6 will be multiplied by 0.43 and whatever value you get will be written here. So it is plus 2.58 and the other value will be plus 3.42. If you add these two values, they will sum up to plus 6 and you will get plus 6 minus 6 so that this value joint will get balanced. Same is the case about this joint. Here the unbalanced, this is plus 6 and this is 0. So there is an error of plus 6. So we will apply a correction of minus 6 and that minus 6 will be distributed at 0.57 by on this joint side and 0.43 on this side. So minus 6 into 0.57, minus 6 into 0.57, this will be minus 3.42 and this will be minus 2.58. How this minus 2.58 has come? Minus 6 into 0.43. So a total correction moment of minus 6 is distributed in this proportion at this point, so this part of B and that part of B. So this is how we release the joints at B and C. Now if we take the total, we will find that the total will be plus minus equal values. So that will mean that the joints are really released. Now we know even if we release the joints, there is one difficulty as a property of beam itself, that if you apply any external moments here at any end of the beam, half of it gets, half means 50% of it gets carried to the other end if the other end is fixed or continuous. So this 2.58 kilonewton meter moment, way out of this 50% will automatically go here. That is the property of beam. So what we will do is we will have to show that carryover, that we call as the carryover moment. Here we have released actually. So this could have, here the problem should have ended actually when we have released. But the problem does not end there, because whenever you release, you apply some moments to release it, and whenever you apply some moments, half of that moment goes to the other support. That is called as carryover moment. So carryover. Now carryover is possible only to a fixed support or a continuous support. So this applied moment of 2.58 can get carried over to A. So from B to A the carryover is possible, because A is a fixed support. So the carryover, usually we show it by an arrow like this. So this carryover moment will be half of this, so it is 1.29. Half of this plus 2.58, half of this is 1.29. Now will this get carried over? All the moments you have added are to be carried over, if that is possible. Now this 3.42 is due for this support. Now is this support ready to receive? Yes, because this is a continuous support. So carryover is possible at a continuous support and at a fixed support. So this 3.42 will get carried over. That half of 3.42 is 1.72. We have to note that the sign of carryover moment is same as the original moment. So if this is plus, this is also plus. This is plus, this is also plus. Now this moment, this is additionally applied moment, it will get carried over to this from C to B. Now is this B eligible? Yes, it is eligible, because it is a continuous support. So carryover moment is possible. So this is minus 3.42, so half of that will be taken back, so it will be minus 1.72. You have to retain the same sign. Now this 2.58 minus 2.58, can it go here? It can go here, because this support is ready to receive, because it is a fixed support. So you must show it here. So this is minus half of 2.58 is 1.29, minus 1.29. So the release was done and the mistakes were actually cleared, but as a consequence of that, some new moments have come to the supports. That is what we find. So this carryover moments are the additional moments which create a new imbalance. This is what we understand from the method of moment distribution, that this again at this support you get minus 1.72 and 0. So these are, there are unequal moments again. So these moments create again an imbalance, and we are again required to release this support. Okay. This report is again required to be released. So whenever there is a carryover, we have to again release the support. This is a cycle. So again we will say release of B and C. Now why are we releasing B and C? Because there is an imbalance. Ideally we want some plus value and the same minus value here, so that it will become a continuous support. But it's not there. 0 and minus 1.72. Now this is 0 and minus 1.72, means there is an error of minus 1.72. So I should apply a correction of plus 1.72. So a correction moment of plus 1.72 on this entire joint. So 1.72 out of that 0.43 will go here and 0.57% will 57% will go here. So correction is plus 1.72. So it is 0.74. You get 0.74. How this 0.74 has come? This is total correction is plus 1.72 into 0.43 gives 0.74. Now is remaining 57% is 0.98. So here we have released the joint B again by applying these correction moments. Here it is plus 1.72. Now we will be talking about joint C. Plus 1.72. So it will be released. So minus 1.72 will be distributed in the proportion 0.57 and 0.43. So this will be released. So we will get here minus 0.98 and minus 0.74. After you release the joints, actually that step is over. After you have released the joints, it means that you have made the things clear. But after every release, there is an additional problem. So every release comes with a free problem. That problem is half of the moments you have given will be getting carried over. So again there will be a carryover moment. So let us see how much will be the carryover moment. This 0.74 was applied here. So the carryover moment will come here. So let us continue for one cycle and then decide something more. So this will, just as this 1.29 came from here, half of this 0.74 will come and this will be plus 0.37. Similarly, this 0.98 will be transferred here and it will become 0.49. Similarly, this will be carried over here. So this is minus 0.49. And this 0.74 minus, this will get transferred here and it will become minus 0.37. This is our usual moment distribution method. So half moments are carried over. So again the same story repeated, that the carryover moments up to release it was okay, but the carryover moments have again created an imbalance. Here the moments are 0 and 0.49, minus 0.49, plus 49, 0. So there is an imbalance again. So imbalance will have to be cleared. So you will have to release again. Release of B and C. How to release B and C? What is the imbalance at B and C? At B, the moment is minus 0.49. So you will have to apply a correction of plus 0.49. So apply a total moment of 0.49 and distribute it in proportion of 0.43 and 0.57. So this is 0.49 plus 0.49 into 0.43. So this will give us 0.21. It will be plus 0.21 because the correction is, this is minus, so correction will be plus. And here it will be, the remaining part will be plus 0.28. So the joint B is balanced. Now we go to joint C. Again the same story is there, 0.49. So this will be minus 0.28 and this will be minus 0.21. -0.28 and -0.21. After the release, you have closed actually. Now we know that there is going to be again carryover. Now in moment distribution method, if you are really theoretical only, you will find that this cycle will never end. This cycle will never end because to do the release, you will always have some distribution of moment, and half of them will get distributed. They will always create, go on creating imbalance. So, in a practical way, if we look at the carryover moments, firstly, the carryover moment was 1.29. In the second cycle, it got reduced to 0.37. Right? So, if this is 0.21 now, it will be halved here and this will be halved here. This 0.49 will go. So, you will find that the amount of carryover moment will go on reducing. The magnitude of carryover moment goes on reducing. So, the moment distribution method stops at a certain point and it says that don't take that carryover anymore. Don't take that carryover anymore because it is negligibly small. Theoretically it will come, but practically it will be insignificant. So ignore it and stop the cycles. Now here the stage has come because this 0.28 will be going here as 0.14. So that 0.48 as compared to the original value 6 is very, very small and we will be ignoring that. So we will stop the whole thing here. That means we will not create any more imbalance at B and C. We will not create any more imbalance at B and C by carryover of the moments. But we will carry over the moment at A. There is no harm in that. There is no imbalance caused at A. So we will transfer this at 0.105, half of 0.21, and this is half of -105. This will be carried over. This arrow indicates that it is carried over, but we will not carry over this 0.28 here and this 0.8 here, so that there is no imbalance caused at B and C. But carryover is taken at A and B because they are not, there is no imbalance there. So with this, we come to the end of this cyclic exercise of this releasing and carryover, releasing and carryover, releasing and carryover. And now we will simply add all the moments and calculate the final values. So what are going to be the final values? I will write here final values. So the final values are just the total of this 1.29 plus this plus this. So this total comes out to be plus 1.76. Then you add this. I have written this red because this is not a moment, this is a distribution factor. It is to be added here. So it is plus 3.53. Then when you will add all these, minus 6 and all, you will get automatically this as minus 3.50. If you will add this from 6 onwards, you will get minus 3.53 again. Sorry, plus 3.53. Now it will be minus 3.53. This will be plus 3.53. Minus. And the last value will be minus 1.76. So this is how we get the final values of moments and the moment distribution table ends here. So we can say that the bending moments at A, B, C and D, A, B, C and D are (1.76 kN) bending moment at B equal to 3.53 kN bending moment at C also 3.53 kN and bending moment at D equal to 1.76 kN. Now we have to remember that these are the values for this particular beam and they are to be finally transferred to this bending moment, this portal frame, and the bending moment is diagram is to be drawn on this portal frame and not on this beam. Okay, so at this moment this is going to be our step 3 and completion of the moment distribution table. There will be step 4 in which we will be drawing the bending moment diagram for the portal frame. So friends, we are solving a problem on portal frame using moment distribution method. We have solved up to step 3. The step 4 is drawing the bending moment diagram for the portal frame. We will cover that in the next video. So goodbye till the next video.